She looks like she's in a pool, and these puffy parts here are just keeping her afloat. Hey V-Bets, I'm back, and today we're gonna be checking out Sparkle Girlz, which might seem like something I've done before, and you are absolutely correct, because if you recall Jen with super poofy, awesome pink hair, then that would be the video where I opened a bunch of different Sparkle Girlz products that were sent to me for free and gave you guys an honest review. And unfortunately, some of the dolls that I received actually had pink gunk all over their arms. My biggest problem is that the skin is stained. I'm not sure if you can see it very well, but her arm looks like it's covered in pink highlighter, and it's also showing up on her face, as well as her legs. And I thought initially that it was from her clothes, but I don't really see very much pink that could rub off, so I'm not sure if that's even the reason. And I wasn't sure if that was their quality standard for their budget dolls, or if it was marks from their clothing, or as I thought of later, it could have been from the confetti they came packaged in. And when I received an email a while later from the PR people for the dolls, offering me new stuff saying that that wasn't their quality, I decided they should be looked at again. But instead of accepting their offer for more free stuff, I went out and bought some of my own. So I did purchase one that was identical to a doll I received, and then two more random ones. Unfortunately, the selection wasn't that great, but hey, it's a good enough selection to let us see what the quality will be like, and that's what matters. Now that you're all caught up as to why we're doing Sparkle Girlz again, we're gonna switch down to the table so we can see everything close up and in high detail. Hey guys, Jen in the future here. Just wanted to let you know that I've filmed this twice. So what you're about to see is actually the original footage, which you'll be able to recognize by the pink nail polish. And the intro and outro somehow got deleted and I had to redo it. For that, I have blue polish. So if for some reason you noticed that or were about to in a second, now you know what happened. We can all laugh, ha ha ha, Jen's got a weird brain and things went wrong, but the problem has been fixed. And now on to the rest of the video. First up, we have this really pretty pastel unicorn princess. She's got long purple hair with sparkly green tinsel in the front, which is sort of pulled back on either side of her head and held together behind her ears as part of a bigger ponytail. You could take this one out if you wanted to and her hair would hang down, and also gives me a chance to see how much shedding we have. And surprisingly, there's none, but we are losing an awful lot of glitter. But to be fair, that happens with almost any doll that has glitter as any part of them. Actually, let's check out what her rooting is like. It's kind of hidden in there. It's surprisingly good. Like, there's no overly large bald spots. Continuing on, she has some ears on top of her head, which matches her lightly tanned skin complexion. She has a purple unicorn horn and a crown of pink flowers. For her face and makeup, everything here looks really good. She's got some brown eyebrows, bright green eyes, loads of black mascara, a hint of blushing on her cheeks, and a light pink lipstick. There is one small dot of paint beneath her right eye, but to be honest, it sort of reminds me of a beauty mark. And overall, she's just really cute. Moving on to her dress, it is super cute, very pastel. We've got a glittery ruffle pink collar with a blue ribbon rose in the center. We've got a pink middle with some hints of blue, purple, and green, and some shiny details. And the skirt is just a pastel tie-dye wonderland. So there's pinks, greens, blues, purples, and loads of glitter, which sadly, as mentioned, is flaking off, and some super cute unicorn heads. And it's not as stiff and starchy as others that I've seen, and it appears to be very well made. And then for her shoes, we have little ballet flats, and these come off in a really cool way. It's kind of like a zip tie. I don't know if you guys can see it. So there's a little arrow section. It looks sort of like a Christmas tree, and you pop it through the little loop. Ta-da! And these are translucent pink with embedded silver glitter. The best kind of glitter. And they slide right on. So I guess you didn't have to do that at all. When it comes to articulation, these dolls have your standard 5 points, which makes perfect sense for their price. These are around $5 to $7, depending on where you live. So that would be their heads, which do have a full 360 plus a tilt, their arms, and their legs, and offer some pretty Olympic results, if you ask me. So that's it for this doll here. Sadly, they don't have any names, so I'm gonna call her Lila. And we'll move on to our next, which has a very familiar face because she's one of the ones I checked out in the past, except now she has zero pink marks on her. Let's go ahead and take off her elastic bands. Ah! She stood up on me. I love how shiny their hair is. Also, so far we have lost zero of it, which is lovely. Hold on, I've decided I'm gonna open both at the same time. Make our lives easier. Sadly, she looks a little unkempt and in need of a hair brushing, but other than that, we are good to go. So here are the final two dolls we're checking out today. Just like the first one, these have a lightly tanned skin complexion and the exact same face and makeup, except they have blue eyes. Actually, they have open mouth smiles as well. For this one here, we've got long pink hair with some shiny blue tinsel in the front, wrapped around the back with a twist on one side and secured with a clear elastic band. Like I said, we don't have very much shedding here and the hair is very shiny and silky. And I'm not seeing anything wrong with the face or makeup. Her dress is blue on top with a gold sequined collar, very puffy pink sleeves, and a poofy pink skirt with rainbow unicorns, starbursts, and tons of glitter. And she's got some darker pink slippers. Now, when it comes to the quality of her outfit, I'm not really taking it off because I really don't want to have glitter all over the place, but everything on the inside that I can tell immediately does look pretty good. There are some pieces of string, but when I tug on them, they're not going anywhere. Like there's one over here as well, and one down at the bottom. But like I said, they aren't coming loose, so I'll just trim those up later and we should be good to go. So that's it for our pink-haired princess here, who does of course still need a name, so I'm gonna go with Rosie. Which brings us to our final doll, the one with the long blue hair with some magenta tinsel in the front, and it's not pulled back in any way, except for the initial elastic bands that I took off. To be honest, it didn't look much like a style, but it's very possible that it was meant to be, and perhaps I ruined it. Just like the other dolls, there isn't much shedding here, so that's good, but there is quite a good deal of hair coming out of her neck, so I'll have to trim that off. But other than that, everything looks good. I already pointed out that her makeup and face is the same, except she's got blue eyes, so that means we can move on to her dress. So it's a little stiff from being in package, and I'll have to try to hold that down a bit, but I think I can accurately, wait, maybe not. She kind of looks like she's about to take flight. It looks even funnier if I have her seated. Ah! She looks like she's in a pool and these puffy parts here are just keeping her afloat. Oh boy. Anyways, so the top section of the dress is yellow with tons of glitter. We've got a magenta tulle off the shoulder collar. I think it's tulle and it totally matches these big poofy sections here which go over the sides of her skirt. I think it's supposed to be like panniers, maybe. Don't quote me. You can't because there's no comments. And underneath that, we have a very large white skirt covered in super cute colorful unicorns and loads more glitter. And her shoes are the same magenta color. And I think her name should be River because of her blue hair. Oh, I almost forgot her flower. She's got a little purple flower on top with a blue ribbon. Back to this. I think her name should be River. Hey guys, me again. And I'm here to say that that's it for me and Sparkle Girlz 2.0. At the end of the day, I still feel the exact same way about these dolls. They offer good quality hair and makeup, and even the clothes are pretty nicely made, even if they are a little starchy and have a tendency to rain glitter. Eventually, through play, that will stop and the fabric will become softer, making these a great budget-friendly gift for birthdays, Christmas, or even to pick up and donate around the holidays. And the most important news is that they don't have pink marks. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video, and if you did and haven't yet, then please consider subscribing to this channel so you don't miss out on any future fun toy reviews. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!